Hello everyone! In this video we'll explore the DeFi sector of Hedera Hashgraph Layer 1 network, and particularly how to use its pioneering decentralized exchange, SourceSwap. Hedera is an enterprise-grade public network with fast transactions and low fees. With recent upgrade of its smart contract system, Hedera is really attractive in terms of DeFi and NFT sectors. I really encourage you to learn more about it, but now we continue with practical guide. First things first, we need to get to Hedera chain. Let's create a wallet. I chose Hashpack, which is a leading wallet for HBAR. Personally, I like that it allows to view NFTs right in the wallet. Next part, sending funds to the chain. A nice option is bridging from Ethereum or Polygon blockchains using Hashport, official application supported by the HBAR Foundation. And here I'd prefer Hashpack Chrome extension over web application, because extension allows to connect directly without importing Hedera account and pasting private key. You can find the links in the description, but you know, double-checking is a good practice in crypto. So we connect two wallets, HBAR wallet and ETH or Polygon one. In my case it's Ethereum and a popular option MetaMask. Then just go to porting. If something goes wrong, like this, you can repeat. And here we go. But there's one thing, if you don't have HBAR in the wallet yet, bridging process is likely to fail. So make sure to get some HBAR first. Obvious option for Hashpack is to buy HBAR in wallet using MoonPay, or send some from centralized exchanges. And of course, there is a faucet, provided by the hero of today's video, SourceSwap, and I'd say it's probably the most credible one. To get some free HBAR, go to SourceSwap Discord, pass CAPTCHA, look for account link in channel and follow instructions in pinned messages. But read the instructions for the faucet carefully, as you need to spend transaction fees to associate every token in order to swap, and the faucet provides tokens enough only for one such association. To start using the dApp or decentralized application, you should connect it in the wallet by getting the link or QR code on SourceSwap website. Finally, we are ready for action. SourceSwap is a booming brand new decentralized exchange, but backed by the Hedera Foundation and really security-oriented. A peer-to-peer marketplace where users can trade cryptocurrencies in a non-custodial manner. So let's make a trade. We swap tokens right from the wallet with the help of self-executed smart contracts. And it's the users who make it possible, by adding funds to the liquidity pool and by that stabilizing exchange rates. As we basically trade against this liquidity pool, it's worth paying attention to slippage, price moving against traders' action as liquidity is absorbed during the swap. The best way to mitigate it is basically adjusting slippage limit. Let's get back to liquidity providers. They put two crypto assets in proportion 50-50 into the liquidity pool and earn interest from trading fees. Any user can do this, thus becoming an esteemed liquidity provider and receiving LP tokens here on liquidity tab. By pairing HBAR and Source, we get corresponding LP tokens, which can be redeemed back to two separate assets. Basically, these tokens already entitle the holder with a share of the fees, but to maximize the yield, we can stake LP tokens in yield farms. Here on SourceSwap, they are known as crop circles, and as you can see, there are plenty of them. Here's one with HBAR and Source. A certain fee is charged when you stake the assets, but look at the annual percentage rate. This is called yield farming, receiving token emissions, in our case it's primarily Source, for staking two assets in a pool. With established and legitimate projects like SourceSwap, yield farming may be really profitable, but always remember about the risks, as crypto market is, you know, very volatile. Every yield farmer should know about impermanent loss. When you stake two crypto assets in liquidity pool, you have a certain ratio between them, but over time with the price of one asset rising or falling against another, this ratio may change and some loss occurs. While funds remain staked in the form of LP tokens, this loss is impermanent, but when they are claimed, the loss is realized. Experienced yield farmers actively track impermanent loss using different tools. But a general advice here would be simple: don't stake funds that you may need urgently. Impermanent loss is not to be worried about if only one asset is staked, and such feature will soon be available on SourceSwap here in Stake section. Portfolio tab gives a clear overview of your assets on the platform, shares of staked and unstaked coins, what farms you are in and how much rewards you have. Finally, there are settings for currency and slippage tolerance, and this three dots tab leading to profile settings, detailed info about SourceSwap, analytics and test version of the platform, where you can experiment with the concepts of these decks. The platform's native token, Source, represents its utility functions and, according to the roadmap, is going to play increasingly major role with gaming features, single staking and other innovations coming. Besides, SourceSwap is structured as a decentralized autonomous organization, so community can vote with Source tokens for different proposals on protocol development. Considering all that, SourceSwap may have a big bright future ahead with further development of HBAR ecosystem. Thus, if you see the potential in Hedera, you should definitely hang out on Crop Circles. See you later in Portlock Guides. Stay well and alive.